Let's take a look at another interesting machine learning system that had a little quirk in it. So we were working with a professor of 18th century English literature who had developed a database of metaphors of the mind. Basically, he had gone through all of 18th century literature, and every time an author had said, "the mind is a garden," or "the mind is a blank slate," he had written those down in a database. And he was interested to know whether the metaphors of the mind that an author used were indicative of their political affiliation. Well, it seemed like this is something we could test using machine learning. We'll build a model, see if we can predict these things. So we did this. We created a set of training and test data where each example was one metaphor of the mind that an author had used and the label of the author's political affiliation, Whig, Tory, whatever they did in the 18th century. We divided those up sentence by sentence into test, train, and validation splits, trained up a model, and found that our test validation accuracy was incredibly good. It looked like we could indeed predict an author's political affiliation based only on their metaphors of the mind. Total success. Except then we looked a little deeper and realized that maybe our accuracy was actually suspiciously high. Was there anything here that was going wrong? Well, one of the things that we noticed was that when we created our test, train, and validation splits, we did so by dividing up our examples sentence by sentence. And so if we looked at, say, Samuel Richardson, some of his sentences would end up in the training data, some in the validation data, and some in the test data. This meant that the model had the ability to learn specific qualities about Richardson's use of language beyond just the metaphors that he used, and in a sense get to memorize a little extra stuff about him when it came time to be applied at test time. We ran another experiment where we divided things up at the author level, so that given authors were only in the training data, or only in the test data, or only in the validation data. And when we ran the experiment this time, we found that it was much more difficult to get good accuracy on test data, and thus much more difficult to predict the political affiliation based only on the metaphorical data. So this was kind of interesting. One thing was we got to write two papers, one with each viewpoint. The second was that we learned an important lesson about how critical it is to think about the ways that our training data and test data are randomized for these splits. As a machine learning person, it's easy to think, well, we'll just randomize the data. But we actually have to know what the data represents in order to create these good splits.